not forget to drink your water. Hashtag stay hydrated, guys. Hashtag stay hydrated. Hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technolobe. Last week I reviewed the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max, the top end most expensive variant of the Redmi Note 10 series. It comes with all the bells and whistles and it's one hell of a smartphone. So do not forget to check out that review, it will be linked in the description box below. Now today, we are going to talk about the younger and more affordable brother of the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max. Yes, this phone right over here. The Redmi Note 10. It's the entry-level smartphone in the Redmi Note 10 series, and this phone as well offers a lot of value. So let's talk in detail about the Redmi Note 10. It all starts with the design itself. Redmi Note 10 is a major design refresh and feels more premium than ever. It is lightweight, slim, and very comfortable to hold. In fact, it is more comfortable as compared to Redmi Note 10 Pro Max. So Redmi Note 10 Pro and Pro Max are bigger phones which come with a 6.7-inch display, but Redmi Note 10 comes with a 6.43-inch display which is smaller and more comfortable. Also, this phone is extremely slim and lightweight. It definitely feels like a premium smartphone in terms of design. Now, as far as the build quality goes, here's where Xiaomi has cut corners. So this phone does not have a glass back panel. But I do not mind that. I have said this earlier that I do not mind plastic back panels in budget phones because plastic makes more sense as it does not break easily and it's easy to replace as well. But the plastic back panel on this phone feels very premium. It does not feel cheap at all, and especially in this white color. It has this matte finish which will not attract a lot of fingerprints as well. So if you're planning to get the Redmi Note 10, please get it in this white color. It is absolutely beautiful and it's matte as well. Now the next major upgrade is in terms of the display. So this phone comes with a 6.43 inches Full HD Plus AMOLED display. A Full HD Plus AMOLED display for this price point is just insane. There are phones out there which cost more than this phone and have a 720p LCD display. So it's very good that Xiaomi is giving a Full HD Plus AMOLED display at this point. Now the display quality itself is excellent. It is color accurate, gets bright enough, and the overall media viewing experience on this phone is very good. So if you consume a lot of media on your phone, like watching movies on Netflix or TV shows, or watching videos on YouTube, or in general scrolling through Instagram Reels, all these things are an immersive experience because of that beautiful display. Now this display is only 60Hz, but that's completely okay for the price point. The fact that it is Full HD Plus and AMOLED is enough for this price point. Now you might be wondering, what about performance? Did performance get an upgrade? Yes, it did get an upgrade, but it was not a major upgrade as compared to Redmi Note 9. So this phone comes with a Snapdragon 678 processor. It easily handles all your daily tasks like checking your email, replying to WhatsApp messages, scrolling through Instagram, or just watching videos on YouTube. For all these things, the processor is more than enough. Now when it comes to gaming, I cannot say the same. So gaming performance of this phone is okay-ish, but that is expected given the price of this phone. So it's not a powerhouse by any mean. It is meant for normal day-to-day usage, and for that, Snapdragon 678 is more than enough. Now with that Snapdragon 678, you get a couple of options. 4GB or 6GB of RAM with 64 or 128GB of internal storage. It also comes with a dedicated microSD card slot, which is highly appreciated. Now what about the software? Redmi Note 10 comes with MIUI 12 based on Android 11 out of the box. MIUI 12 is MIUI 12 at the end of the day. It is a very heavy skin on top of Android with tons and tons of features. But the good thing is that Xiaomi has optimized MIUI 12 for the Redmi Note 10. In fact, the RAM management on this phone is better than Redmi Note 10 Pro Max. Yes, believe it or not, it is better on this phone. So Xiaomi has optimized the software quite a bit, but there's a long way to go. Now Xiaomi has said that MIUI 12.5 is just around the corner, and I am very excited for MIUI 12.5. It is supposed to clean up things quite a bit. You can also uninstall some system apps in MIUI 12.5. So that is a thing that I'm waiting for. Maybe I will ask Xiaomi to enroll me in the beta program so that I can make a preview video for you guys and tell you about the features. Let's see what happens on that. I will keep you guys updated on Twitter. As far as the battery goes, it comes with a 5000 mAh battery and 33W fast charging. And here's the sweet thing, it comes with a charger inside the box itself. That is just excellent. So Xiaomi did a very good job over here by giving the charger inside the box itself. You get super fast charging at this price point and it is convenient AF. Now as far as the battery life goes, the battery life is excellent. It will easily last you throughout the day and some part of the next day as well. If you're a very light user, it might last you for 2 days. So battery life is excellent, I have no complaints over there. Now this gets me to one of the main things in any smartphone these days, and that is them cameras. So on the rear side, there is a quad camera setup, a 48 megapixel primary sensor. Now this is the Sony IMX582. With that, it has an 8 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, a 2 megapixel macro camera, and a 2 megapixel depth sensor. What about the actual images? Well, the images are very good considering the price of this phone. It is one of the best phones out there in terms of the cameras. The photos are good in terms of detail level, the dynamic range is decent enough, and the colors are on point. So the colors are not off, and that is one thing that I really liked. Normally in budget phones, the colors are way off sometimes, but that is not the case. And also this camera is consistent. It is not inconsistent, which is very good and shows that Xiaomi has done a good job in terms of the software. So camera software is stable and consistent. This phone also has a night mode, but only for the main camera, not for the ultra wide angle camera, only for the main camera, and that is completely okay. Night mode will help you capture good photos in low lighting conditions as well. Now what about the front camera? It comes with a 13 megapixel shooter and selfies are just okay. Not too good and not too bad either. I would say the selfie camera is just normal, nothing exciting over here. All in all, the camera experience is very good for the price. It comes with a lot of features in the camera app as well. Xiaomi has not cut down on the software features in the budget phone, and that is very good. This gets me to other little things. This phone comes with an IR blaster, which is a very underrated feature of Xiaomi phones. It also has a pair of dual stereo speakers, which are very good. The speakers are loud, clear, and frankly very good for the price of this phone. Apart from that, it also has a side-mounted fingerprint sensor. That means it is integrated into the power button and works like a charm. It is a physical fingerprint sensor, which is fast and accurate as well. Redmi Note 10 also has a very good haptic motor. Haptic motor kind of gets overlooked with budget phones, but not with the Redmi Note 10. It does have a very good haptic motor. So overall, Redmi Note 10 is more polished than ever. Xiaomi has put in a lot of effort into this phone, and that is clearly shown with the little things. It is not rough around the edges, and that is what I appreciate. It feels like a complete phone and more premium than ever before. Xiaomi has done a great job with this phone, and if you want to buy one, you can definitely do so. I will make sure to drop a link to it in the description box below. So anyway, this was my full review of the Redmi Note 10. Do let me know how you feel about this video in the comment section down below. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. My name is Harsh Punjabi, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.